So 10 of the roles that are trending right now, the 10 roles that are recruiters are going crazy for, companies are wanting these people with these skills. And what are the responsibilities of these 10 roles? First, I'd like to thank InMotion Hosting for sponsoring this part of the video. So launching your website is easier than you think. I use InMotion Hosting, which is a premium web hosting company that provides domain regos, web design services, managed hosting, and much more. And to get started, I'd recommend that you register for the InMotion Hosting. They even have servers running the super fast NVMe's SSD drives up to 20 times faster than traditional hard drives. Get a free domain and free SSL and host unlimited websites starting at just $4.99. So to get started and get your hosting plan, click on that link in my description below. So I release videos every single week on all things tech. So do remember, because you're on YouTube, you need to subscribe clicking on the button on the bell. And also let me know in the comments what you're currently doing in tech. Are you working in a company, in a small, medium, or large company? What sort of role are you doing right now? What role do you want to be getting into? So we're going to be ranking these from the 10 to the number one being the most desirable role right now. So we're not ranking them necessarily by salary, but really their demand. So if you have these skills, you're gonna be more sought after. Now we'll also give you the salaries of each of these roles. Now these are based on US dollars. This is at 2022. So 10 of the roles that are trending right now. So number 10 are your support analysts, your support specialists, your technicians. These are roles that are sort of used across pretty much every single company that has some sort of an IT presence. These are gonna be commonly your level two sort of people. So level ones being your help desk-y, basic IT troubleshooting on the phone, that sort of stuff. Well, your level two, this is where this sits. These are people who are gonna be on the floor, fixing computers, troubleshooting things, maybe doing some server admin here or there, but those skills are gonna be pretty sought after. Now these folks are gonna be starting off at around $60,000 per year and sort of work their way up. So if you're looking for that role, learn about troubleshooting, learn about basics of computers, operating systems, software, learn about Active Directory, things of that nature. $60K to get you started. Number 9 is a web developer. Administering websites, they're building websites, they're supporting websites. So this is gonna be a very, very broad skill set. They're gonna be maybe experienced with the big CMS, such as WordPress, Drupal, Joomla, those sort of things. But they're also gonna be in demand if they have experience around HTML, CSS, PHP, they know that sort of stuff, they're gonna be in more high demand. And for web developers, you're looking at roughly $70,000 upwards. Number 8 is systems admins and systems engineers. These are people who are in level 3. So we talked about level 1, level 2, and then level 3 are the people who are a little bit more senior, who are now infrastructure focused, and they're now looking after server technologies, cloud technologies, storage technologies, backups, monitoring, perhaps some security. Your systems admins are a little bit lower than your systems engineers, but you're sort of looking at a starting range of around $70,000 to $80,000 and up. We then closely follow that with number 7, which is your network admins and network engineers. Your network engineers are gonna be starting at around the $80,000 to $90,000, and now they're responsible for more networking focused responsibilities. Looking after the security, looking after firewalls, routers, switching, proxies, load balancers, all of that sort of technology, understanding about different link types between one site to another, making sure that all of that is running healthy, secure, and running well. Number 6 are your architects. Now we're specifically talking here about your systems and your network architects. But these are people almost like a level 4. They're a little bit step up from your systems and network admins and engineers. These are people who are now more architecture focused. They're thinking big picture, they have all the pieces of the puzzle and they put it together and then they form the nice overall architecture of a network or a system for an organization. They're gonna need to be not only technical, be able to architect things and design things very, very well. They are a little bit of a step up from your systems and your network engineers. And we're gonna say roughly they're gonna be starting at around the 90 to 100K, but they can go up very, very high the more experienced they are. Generally, the larger the company, the more these folks are going to make because there's a lot of technology here that they need to make sure that all fits together and is architected well. Number 5, these people are very, very sought after, even For years, these people have been sought after. And this is the database administrators, the DBAs, people who are looking after databases. Databases, of course, are the back end of a lot of applications, of a lot of web apps, those sort of things, making sure that they understand around SQL, around Oracle, around other sorts of database technologies. DBAs could be starting off at around the 110 to 120,000. Number four are security people. Now, this is a role that is so trending right now. So security analysts, security administrators, security engineers, people who are responsible for the security across a company. And of course, they're gonna work very closely with other administrators, with your database people, with your engineers, but the security people make sure that everything is running well, that it's secure, that it's patched, that the vulnerabilities are there, that they're doing things such as pen testing, penetration testing. They are ultimately responsible for making sure that all of the data, all of the systems, all of the network is secure from infection, from infiltration, from hacking, from all of this. Security people are gonna be starting at around the $90,000, but they're gonna jump up quite dramatically. And again, it depends on the company itself, it depends on the industry and the size, because they can get into the very high dollars. Number three are your general managers. So these are your IT managers, infrastructure managers, service delivery managers, development managers, even your CIOs and CTOs. These roles are always in high demand because they look after the whole lot. We've talked about these engineers, we've talked about architects, we've talked about database admins. Well, all of these people need to report into a manager. And generally these are gonna be IT managers of some sort, of a different stripe of IT manager. An IT manager could be starting off at roughly $120,000, but they're gonna be working their way up. And IT managers, if you're getting into the high directors, heads of your C-level, so your CIO, CTO, CISO, the CISOs, those chiefs could be earning $300,000, $400,000, $500,000 or more. Really depends on the company, their level of responsibility. But hey, look, if you wanna learn more about IT management, I've got a full length training course. If this is one of the skills that you want to know, in my show notes, in my description below, I've got a IT manager training course. You watch that, you'll learn more about what the IT manager does and the skills that you need to become an IT manager. Number two, software developers. These are people who are making stuff. So mobile apps, apps design, UI, UX, so the user interface and the user experience, anything that sort of falls under the development suite. Now they're gonna need to learn a lot of different sorts of languages, C#, do C++, old school VB.net and other sorts of languages, but developers are a huge thing. I know a lot of developers, and these developers, it's very hard to get them because as soon as they leave a company, they're snatched up. Now the developer salary range is going to range dramatically, but they will generally start around the 100K mark, but then work their way up depending on their level of experience, depending on the technology that they're working on. They could earn a lot of money if they're very good at their coding and development. And drum roll, the number one here is a data scientist. So they evaluate data, they help companies, they do things such as data analytics. Now you may have heard the terms business analyst and systems analyst and these sort of roles. Well, think about that on steroids would be somebody who's like a data scientist. Somebody who can manipulate, articulate data very well and put that data to use to benefit that company. The company who knows about the data, who knows about their metrics, who knows about the analytics is gonna be a lot more successful, and that is what a data scientist does. A data scientist will start around the 120 range, but will go up from there. Top 10 done. Let me know in the comments what you thought. What are you? What is your role right now in your company? Which one of these 10 do you want to become? And because you're watching this on YouTube, I would also love it if you click on that subscription button and on the bell. I release videos every single week on all things tech. So do that so that you don't miss out on anything. Thanks so much. We'll talk to you next time.